What's the first step in developing for HoloLens 2? Our best recommendation is to get familiar with Mixed Reality Toolkit, or MRTK V2, as we call it. This is the same toolkit that's been around since the first generation of HoloLens. It's evolved and it's had great contributions from folks in the community. We wouldn't be where we are today without your contributions. Over the past 3 years, we've learned a lot and taken feedback. We've made updates to make it more modular, so you don't have to take the big monolithic toolkit into your project. You can just take the pieces that you need, so your project's more manageable and it's smaller. Additionally, it lets you go and swap from the defaults of the toolkit, and you can bring in your own system services and support other platforms as you desire. From a cross-platform support, the toolkit itself doesn't have cross-platform support out of the box, but none of the code in the toolkit is expected to break when you target other platforms with your builds. Additionally, because we want to support mobile platforms, we want to make sure the toolkit is performant so that when you're running your applications for mobile platforms, we can expect them to have high performance. We're very dedicated to ensure that the toolkit is supported from a platform perspective. Our commitment starts with having some of our in-box experience for HoloLens 2 built using the same toolkit. Our out-of-box experience, or our setup application, as well as our mixed reality learning applications, were built using Mixed Reality Toolkit. So, any new capabilities that you want to see for HoloLens 2, they'll first show up in Mixed Reality Toolkit version 2.